I love you very much, and I'm very happy that this day is happening. Steve, you're the best stepdaddy we could wish for, and you're perfect, and you're so much better than all the Daves who came before.
That's not going on the film.
I
love you loads.
Marriage in this country is the union of two people voluntarily entered into for life to the exclusion of all others. I will now ask each of you in turn to declare that you do not know of any lawful reason why you should not be married to each other. And Stephen, my traditional start with himself. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare
that I know not.
That I know not
of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Stephen Clark.
Why I, Stephen Clark.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Isabel Rowena Malinowski.
To Isabel Rowena Malinowski.
I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare
that I know not.
That I know not
of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Isabel Rowena Malinowski.
Why I, Isabel Rowena Malinowski.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Stephen Clark.
To Stephen Clark.
One of the most privileged roles at a wedding is to present the bride. And to formally acknowledge this role, I ask who presents Isabel to be married to Stephen.
I do.
You step forward, please, Jo. So can you pass for Isabel's hand to Stephen? And now that special moment has come for Stephen and Isabel to contract their marriage before you, their witnesses. These words of you, so if you can look at each other holding hands. I, Stephen Clark.
I, Stephen Clark.
Take you.
Take you.
Isabel Rowena Malinowski.
Isabel Rowena Malinowski.
To be my wedding wife. I, Isabel Rowena Malinowski.
I, Isabel Malinowski.
Take you.
Thank you.
Stephen Clark. To be my wedded husband. So that's the legal bits over now. Children to say some promises to each other. Stephen, if I can ask you to repeat that to me, please. Isabel, I promise to laugh with you in joy.
Isabel, I promise to laugh with you in joy.
Grow with you in love.
Grow with you in love.
To be faithful to you.
To be faithful to you.
And to cherish and respect you always.
And to cherish and respect you always.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Stephen, I promise to laugh with you in joy.
Stephen, I promise to laugh with you in joy.
Grow with you in love.
Grow with you in love.
To be faithful to you.
To be faithful to you.
And to cherish and respect you always.
And to cherish and respect.
As long as we both shall live. Your wedding ring is an unbroken circle symbolising everlasting love and is the outward sign of the lifelong promise we've made to each other. Wear these rings with love and pride, now and always. Can I ask the best men, Stephen, to come forward with the rings, please? And can we have Isabel's? Sorry, can't read my own writing, sorry. Can we have Isabel's ring first, please? And place her third finger left hand, just to the left. Just to the left. If you can say these words out loud. Isabel, I give you this ring.
Isabel, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my endless love for you.
As a symbol of my endless love for you.
And as a pledge to respect you.
And as a pledge to respect you.
And to grow with you.
And to grow with you.
For the whole of my life.
The whole of my life.
Wish you well. Place on third finger left hand, just give you this ring.
Stephen, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my endless love for you.
As a symbol of my endless love for you.
And as a pledge to respect you.
And as a pledge to respect you.
And to grow with you.
And to grow with you.
For the whole of my life.
For the whole of my life.
Thank you, Jackie.
Cahill Gibran. You were born together, and together you shall be forever. You shall be together when the white wings of death scatter your days. Aye, you shall be together even in the silent memory. But let there be spaces in your togetherness, and let the winds of heaven stand between you. Love one another, but make not a bond of love. Let it rather be a moving sea between the shores of your souls. Fill each other's cup, but drink not from one cup. Give one another of your bread, but eat not from the same loaf. Sing and dance together and be joyous. But let each other be alone, even as the strings of the lute are alone when they quiver. Give your hearts, but not into each other's keeping. For only the hand of life can contain your hearts. And stand together, yet not too near. For the pillars of the temple and stand apart, and the oak tree and the cypress tree grow not in each other's shadow.
Quality of Love, Abridged by Isabel Malinowski, 2010. Show me a love that stands the test of time, beholds its prize through eyes bewitched, beguiled, before a faded bloom beyond its prime, to see the sweetest rose or flower wild. Show me a love that does not ask for all, nor seeks the easy path in life to tread, sees every facet to a fractured whole, yet loves enough to be by blindness led. Show me a love that does not seek to change, to chip, to hew, to mould, instead to hold sweet imperfection to the brightest light, delight, as though the dullest lead were gold. Show me a love where two minds meet as one, sweet appetite by word and language fed, a heat to melt a frozen landlocked tear, swell hearts with hope upon the hemlocked bed. Then I should say that Romeo lives, breathes, that Juliet sleeps, perchance, one day, to dream.
Thank you, Kate. We have heard you promise to share your lives in marriage. Cherish your love for each other. Enhance the potential you have as individuals and as a couple. And to look to your future with a commitment that grows deeper and stronger as the years pass. We wish you wisdom and strength to always follow your dreams, happiness, and never-ending love in your new life together. Stephen and Isabel, you have now made the declarations prescribed by law and made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of your witnesses, family, and friends. And having symbolised your marriage by the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, it is my privilege and very great pleasure to announce that you are now lawfully joined in marriage as husband and wife. Would you like to give your wife a kiss? Give them a few more.
buckle up and get stuck. Believe it or not, here comes a brother with glow. A snuggling, bubbling, overweight, loving, hugging pro. So what's it gonna be? Me or the TV? Let me take time to set your mind and your body free. So why don't you just stretch, stretch, stretch for a sec? Lay while the bottle's like a cop, a quick wreck. Shake me, shake me, baby, baby, bake me. No need to fake, here I am, come on and take me. Wind your body, baby, move your body. I see you slip, sliding, come on and do it, hottie. I'm not quite sure as to what is going down, but I'm feeling hunky-dory about to sing what I just found. And I schooled her, but not like this. We can toss and turn, rumble, tumble, and twist. Anything you want, I give it. Fantasies will live it, so lay down and relax. Love my lady, lady, love my baby girl. Spread your wings so we can fly around the world. Harmony, charm me.
James.
I'm good, thank you.
I'm not, if I look like this at 94, I'll be a very lucky lady.
I'm sure you will.
Absolutely.
You go in the middle with that.
Two tall ones and a small one.
Yeah, that'll do.
Two of the two babies.
Especially the babies and the
pair. Okay, ready? Just a minute, let me get me hat back. Isn't it funny, we got taller as she went along. We got taller, didn't we?
Yeah.
Lovely. Thank you very much.
Thank you, please.
You
want
the rose now?
Yeah. One of us. One of
us. One of us.
One of us.
One of us. One of us. One of us.
No, he's only
A unique event in history.
Oi.
This was the first and the very last time that my wife is going to let me get a word in first.
There's nothing like a man knowing his place.
I'd like to start by thanking everyone here today for sharing our very special day with us. Although we didn't ask for gifts, some people have persisted, and I thank you very much for your generosity. And I'm really looking forward to seeing how Phil and Stephen manage to wrap that wheelbarrow. Most people on their wedding days describe it as the happiest day of their lives. That worries me slightly, because it implies that as from tomorrow, we're on the decline. So I'm going to make most of today. I would like to say a special thank you for those who've travelled from a distance to be here today. But whether your journey has been 5,000 miles or 5 minutes, I thank you all for sharing this day with us. A very special day. And it's quite humbling to realise you've got friends and family that love you so much and care for you so much. So thank you for that. I must say I've been really impressed by the number of people that have rallied round to help us in preparation for today. And if you're not mentioned by name, and that will be Isabel's task, please be assured that Isabel and I are really grateful. From the moment I got engaged to Isabel, she's hardly stopped planning and arranging things to make sure it all went smooth as it did today. I've been so proud of the way that she's managed to juggle all the responsibilities, organising the wedding and everything else, but remaining calm and understanding. Well, understanding. She's a strong and independent woman. Something I realised the first time we dated, when she decided that we might as well date, as we live near each other. I hadn't realised when I went onto this dating site that the foremost criteria was the distance from somebody. And if I'd moved back to Standish or taken that flight in Warrington, we'd never have met. Ours was a whirlwind romance. Our first proper date at the Baby Elephant. The waiter couldn't get an order from us because we were so engrossed in each other. He waited for about half an hour, didn't he? And then from that to sort of proposing in Laveri on Lake Izio, so loving Izzy in Izio Naveri. Very poetic, isn't it? It's quite appropriate considering she's a poet. And of course I appreciate how lucky I am. She's a gorgeous woman.
Oh, I agree with you.
And a beautiful bride. She promised me she'd look good in that dress. And she promised me, and then she promised me again. She absolutely looks fantastic. I can guess my wife, I've got to get used to saying that, will mention how compatible we are. So I'll get it in first. It's true. I think with the right blend of compatibility and acceptance of each other's independence, all of which bodes well for the future. One thing that Isabel was totally honest about was the number of kids that she had. But not until she'd hooked me.
Did lie about your age.
Yeah.
You did?
So did you. I must admit that when contemplating the ideal partner, having four children was not the top of my list. However, they're great kids. They are great kids, and we really get along together. I have to thank them for allowing me to get a hug in now and again, where they're not clinging to like limpets. And for Beth, for not giving the cold shoulder like she has been known to do before. Naturally, I'm extremely grateful to Isabel's family, who've welcomed me with open arms. What shines through is how much they all love Isabel and want her to be happy, and I'm privileged to be part of that. Considering I have no musical talent, I'm not wanted to perform in front of an audience, and I like weak tea. It's amazing they've accepted me at all. However, I think that use of the megaphone at the family do's has helped a little bit to get a word in edgeways. With all this gratitude being expressed, it seems appropriate now to thank my dad for my upbringing, or was it my dragging up? I can't remember.
I didn't do nothing.
No, I'm missing it.
I would like to thank him for his unconditional support, for always being there for me. Well, he only lived, like, he lived in the same place for about 10 years.
No, it's been a great role model.
And for the terrible jokes.
Yeah.
It's impossible to sum up how much and how adequately what a great dad he's been, really. And so, it's just a shame he supports the wrong team. So, Dad, I've got a little present for you, so thank you.
Which Andrew will probably bring. Yeah. With Steve. Yeah.
I'll give you
that. And he will.
Yay! Yay.
Finally, I need to thank my best men. Every groom needs a best man who you can totally rely on. Somebody who's organised, who can take charge and make the day run smoothly.
You knew that.
A person who's very serious and responsible. But what do you do when you don't have anyone like that? In my case, I pick Stephen Phil.
Yeah, it's good. You're going first, mate.
A best man needs to be prepared and ready for all eventualities. Included, it seems, as from the stag do, the zombie apocalypse. It's in gratitude for their contributions that I've bought you both a little gift to help you in your struggles.
There we
are. To share.
No, please.
Thank you,
Steve.
Thank you very much.
It'd be a bit lethal without Steve on a zombie experience, couldn't they?
Well, be able to kill some zombies, yeah. I think. Maybe not. I can imagine they're getting very impatient to make their speeches. But I need to remind you that not many people know this, but they both suffer from this rare sort of medical condition which causes them to invent fanciful stories. And they really do believe these, so I just want you to humour them for a little bit. Which reminds me, speaking of speeches, I'm supposed in this speech to propose a toast in honour of the bridesmaids and the flower girls. So, ladies and gentlemen, could I ask you all to raise your glasses in recognition of Jess, Beth, Maria, Anna, Isabel and Rose, for performing their roles so gracefully and for looking fantastic throughout the day.
Cheers.
To the bridesmaids.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Ladies and gents, can we have a big round of applause please for Graham and Steve? Now the most important person in the room, can we have a big round of applause for our best now? For our bride, Isabel, come on.
That, Steve. I thought you had to be kind of brief and concise and never mind.
Criticise
now. I'm scared now because I wrote my speech last night and I've not got my readers on, so I can't read it, so I'm just going to have to try and remember it. I thought I would drag us into the 21st century by letting a woman have her say at her wedding. Yay. I'd also show Steve how it was going to be in our marriage. I want to start by thanking a number of people because things like this don't happen that easily. Lots of people pulled together, in my case particularly because we are so disorganised, lots of people have come together to help us to make this day happen, and I want to thank those people. I'm going to start off by thanking my mum, the most amazing role model, such a strong lady. I think it would be fair to say you haven't had the easiest of lives and an invalid husband and six children, but she showed us how it was done and she showed us how to be strong, and I thank her for that. And I've got a little gift for her somewhere. Here it is, Mum. A little gift thanking you for all those years of sacrifice. Thank you. They were hard.
I don't care, they were good years. Oh. And I've got a group of people around me second to none. Mm.
Not only my children, but my in-laws. Oh. I'd like to say this, how grateful I am that I've got such loving people around me. Thank you.
Actually joking about a toy boy here. Who knows? I also want to extend a huge thank you. I've got five siblings that are amazing. Catherine, John, Eleanor, George, Yoland. I've missed anyone out. there are some low points in everyone's life, and I've had them, and they've seen me through that financially and emotionally. I couldn't have done it without them. And I just want you to know, and I want you to rejoice in this day and my happiness, and I know you will. And I just wouldn't be here without you. Thank you. I hope they won't mind me singling someone out for a little bit of extra praise. It's been really, really hard being a single parent or single working mum. And there's somebody that's been a little bit like a second mother to me from being this high. She made sure that my vest was tucked in my knickers and that I got to school on time, even if she had to make me run all the way. She's just always been there for me. She's helped me out with the kids, getting them to orchestra, getting them to dental appointments. She was our wonderful pianist for the day, my sister Yoland. Here it is. Thank you. thank you so much for everything you've done. She's still tucking me best in my knickers, metaphorically speaking, today. You know, Steve and I aren't the most organised of people, and there's just one more person I'm going to thank lots of people, but I've got flowers for somebody that has just spent hours and hours and hours on my wedding, 7 days, like just organising the table stuff, and she organised all my hen night, and she's just spent so much time. And beyond that, she took my kids under her wing when we came back from Australia. You know, she's been there for them. She's taken them out for me when I haven't been able to take them out because I'm working. She's just done so much for me. Yeah. And I just feel like I have to mark that. So, Rachel, come on down. Buy everyone flowers, but because so many people have helped me, and people are so kind. But you know, I haven't been able to do it for everyone, but there are some thank yous that I would like to extend. I know that Rebecca spent hours and hours on my wedding cake, I believe, and I am so grateful to you because I've looked at it and it is the most beautiful cake. It really is so classy, and I'm so grateful to you. So thank you for that, Rebecca. I want to thank Emma for making me look beautiful on my wedding day. And I said I wasn't going to say that, but I am, because I don't care. Thank you, Emma. I want to thank my new daughter-in-law. Is that right? Daughter? Oh, it's daughter.
Stepdaughter.
I want to thank my daughter.
Daughter.
She's been so welcoming to me, so loving. And it's not easy when something new comes in and marries your father, is it, you know? And she's just been so lovely. And she's so stubborn. I can't think where she gets it from. I love the quality. She's insisted that I have a photographer for the day and organised all that. And I just want to thank you and James for everything you've done for us. I think I've got one last thank you, and that's for the Clarks, for making me so welcoming to their family. Andrew, you make the meanest, most wonderful meat and potato pie. I love our New Year's tradition of having meat and potato pie. In fact, I can't believe this boy is a Withenshaw boy. I'm pretty sure there's got to be a bit of Wigan blood in you somewhere. You must be reincarnated. The most amazing chef when it comes to making pies. You know, I think, actually, I rang Steve up this morning saying, do you want a pie for lunch? We're not going to be able to get to quarter. And he thought that was quite hilarious, but we do like our pies in Wigan, so. I'm marrying into the right family, aren't I? Right. I seem to be doing well without the speech written down, don't I? So I'm on a roll. But I think I thanked everyone. You never gave Joe his whiskey, by the way.
Right.
Joe, we were meant to thank you as well. Thank you. For walking me down the aisle perfectly and for being such a lovely person. I've got to that part of the speech where I can let rip on Steve. If I'm not thanking you, I'm really sorry. I know there's people I probably should have thanked and haven't. Just sort it out on the dance floor later. I want to move on to speaking a bit about Steve. He is, without any doubt, and you know, without everyone can see it, the love of my life. I never thought it was possible to meet somebody I would be so compatible with. He's just got so many qualities that I adore. One of the things that I really love about, I could never ever be bored with Steve. We chat so easily. He's so interesting. And he shows me, it actually opens the world up to me sometimes. I see things from a different perspective. You just, you know, chuck something in there. I think, I hadn't thought about it like that. Sometimes it can be nice, sometimes it can be less so. For example,
In the early days of our relationship, I was like on a bit of a cloud, so happy in love. And we got to talking about true love. And I surmised that maybe lots of people settled for something a lot less than what we had. You know, because it's hard getting perfection, isn't it? And I thought maybe they just settled for something a bit that was near enough, whereas we cut it all. And then Steve said, well, actually, he then started to quote some eminent psychologist who'd written a paper all about true love. And apparently, people who had found true love were actually narcissists. Is that the right word? Narcissists! Because in finding true love, they had actually found somebody that mirrored their own personalities, their own views, their own qualities. So they were actually loving themselves by loving this other person. So I thought, thanks a bunch, Steve. So I'm actually a narcissist, am I? So I just ruminated on that little bit, and I thought, well, I'll summarise my speech. I will just say a few things. If finding true love is self-love and narcissism, then I must be a very special person indeed. I'll explain. If I could read, I'll explain. First, I must be very intelligent, interesting, witty, yet also down to earth, with no trace of arrogance or pomposity. Yeah. Secondly, I must be perceptive, sensitive, and kind, and yet my own person and nobody's doormat. And lastly, but by no means least, I must be very well endowed. With all the qualities you could possibly want in the perfect husband. Ladies and gentlemen, right. Raise your glasses and let's toast true love.
Thank you. Ladies and gents, let's have a big round of applause for our bride, Isabel. Okay guys, we are
to start by saying how amazing everybody looks today.
Hey.
I do know that obviously when you're asked to come to a wedding, it's a big commitment, especially for, I think for the girls, the lads, we just have to have a bit of a jet wash behind the shirts. But I think for the girls, in the front sometimes, I think for the girls, a big commitment. I can just say how amazing you all look. So can we just start by just giving ourselves and everybody here just a clap? Thank you. And can you also just give a shout out for the lads from the stag do from the Zombie Experience. I've managed to catch up with Joe and James and John and Steve.
Definitely Steve.
But I know a few of us, we caught the zombie virus on the Sunday. And then I dragged out for a few days, but it was a really good experience. So if we haven't seen you, you've been to the stag do, we had a really good time. What we did is we went and we did a little experience where we were killing zombies. And the best way I can describe it is imagine 20 fully grown men trying to run up the same stairwell at the same time. And that was why, I've been asked a couple of times why the lads come back with all the injuries.
Bruises.
Yeah, we were pushing each other over, running away from an imaginary zombie with a toy chainsaw, weren't we? Yeah. But did you do all right? Did you get injured? Yeah. But yeah, so we had a really good time. But anyway, today isn't about everybody else. It's about the top table today. It's about the absolutely beautiful Izzy.
Oh, that was good.
Who looks absolutely amazing today. And Mother Joan looks equally as beautiful.
Thank you.
Bit of eye candy there for the girls, Dennis. And for Steve as well. You'll accept, have to accept your role today as being eye candy as well.
All right.
Is that all right? Yeah. So me and Steve first met in the, well, karate 30 years ago, so back in the 80s, I had a full head of hair then. She had a moustache.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, he did. Yeah, I think Magnum PI. Which was cool, it was cool then. It was cool back in the 80s, wasn't it? But then again, fully grown men with ponytails was cool as well. Yeah. So I think you can draw your own conclusion about that. So we got to know each other. We went away to Tenerife for what should have been 7 days, not just me and him. Wasn't that kind of week, was it, mate?
What is you do? At first I thought it was infatuation, but ooh, this lasted so long. But now I find myself wanting, I wanna marry you and take you home. I know.
Mama's having a cruise.
Recycle.